Too Real for TV exclusive.
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 The original music used in these performances have been changed due to copyrights and YouTube guidelines. All footage and music is owned by Too Real for TV.
Too Real for TV. Cash Me Out. DVD on the way. Mr. Silky Slim, Michael Maroy, Too Real for TV. We doing the DVD. And I hope you motherfuckers get a real insight of what this life is. You know what I'm saying? When I say this life, I mean work, 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 work.
It was like a dream, a night to remember. A real life West Coast story. Like I seen it in movies and on music videos. But this was real life. And it was all the way turned up. A perfect night with nothing but love in the air. The PGO entourage had over $1 million in cars pulled up for the Silky Slim performance. Lamborghini, Bentley, a Sling Shot, Mercedes, and a Double R. And I don't mean Range Rover, I mean Rolls Royce. Plenty of fans were showing nothing but love. And beautiful women were everywhere. And there were numerous West Coast legends in the building.
Brand. It ain't just a motherfucking walk of life, it's a way of life. Get in. Get in.
It's your boy Worldwide Tap, man. It's that brand new exclusive Jimi Hendrix. Purple Haze Liqueur, man, it's going down right now. Shout out Bro, Mississippi Slam, it's going down. Orange County Observatory, we got Mac 10, Sugar Free, Kurrupt, you know what I'm saying? It's going down. Major DJ Quick, you know what it is. Hey now, man, we ride. Get in.
And you know, I don't start no songs without, I don't do no show without giving it for my motherfucking big homeboy Nate Dogg.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Tell me what, you fuck with Super Slim music, right?
Oh, man, my favorite artist, though.
You your favorite artist?
Man, Sugar Free over there, Silky right there, you know what I'm saying? Oh, man, triple double dose, man.
What you like about Silky, man?
Say what? You from the streets, though. You from the streets. No, listen. A lot of people ain't from the streets, though. A lot of people ain't down and around, or you don't see them around nowhere. You gonna see that man. You gonna see that man here. You gonna see that man there. You know what I'm saying? Clean record, perfect record. You know what I'm saying? You got a good record. Great record. You ain't gonna hear nothing bad about
you. A good fucking record too, man.
Hey, listen.
I ran your ass, man, a couple times, man. That motherfucker keep coming these flowers.
Yo, check this out, man. Sugar Free. We gonna vote for him for president. Fuck Donald Trump. Free for president. Right? Free for president. You with it?
Goddamn right.
That's right.
Hey, get America pimping again.
Can she be the vice president?
Yeah. Hey, make
pause.
And America beautiful. 360.
Making this shit.
That's David. That's a beautiful shot.
And the
$10,000 whips. We out here, man. You know what I'm saying? TooRealFOrTV, man. You know these motherfuckers, Maroy.
I ain't gonna even lie. I wouldn't even been here tonight if I ain't run into S. We early in the morning.
Asking where he run into me.
While he was checking his traps.
I mean, yeah, though, you know.
I'm like, what's happening now? He said he going to Silky Slim concert. I said, well, Mr. Me Too, goddammit.
Yeah, I don't know. Rap, look out for me.
Day one, hey, can I say something on the camera?
Go on.
This nigga one of the reasons why I started rapping. I went over BH house, I laid a track. BH called me the next day, like, we gotta do an album, right? I'm like, nigga, I ain't trying to spend a whole bunch of money on PT. Like, man, fuck the money, nigga. I need to produce an album on you. He said, nigga, my nigga Spoonie was over here. Rocking your shit. From God in heaven. He wanted to read why I'm rapping, because every time I see him, he tell me. This is MySpace, nigga.
That's how long niggas been grinding, though.
It became one of my closest homeboys. And I don't mean just like for the show, I mean like, when nigga down and out, he's somebody I can call.
It is, you know what I mean?
If I just need somebody to talk to, he's somebody I can call.
It is.
Yeah. Nigga pulled up, nigga didn't say, hey, nigga, can we get in with you? That nigga said, hey, my nigga, you need somebody, nigga. Nigga, you need somebody, nigga, to hold CDs or whatever, pass out CDs, my nigga, I'm there with you. And mind you, him saying this is different. I'm not gonna say this nigga's a professional poker player. Big time poker player.
Hey, yo, you my main man, baby, way. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, Cole, this is young R. Kelly right here. I'm making, man. Y'all don't even know, man. You want to hit record, man? Put this nigga on the hook.
4A Bone the Pimp. You know what I mean? Mr. PGO, your folks' favorite folks in right thing.
Mr. Silky.
Sling Shot Boy.
All in one night, I was able to witness performances by Kurrupt, Suga, DJ Quick, and the West Coast legend responsible for making the Crip walk famous, Dub C, all in one night. For the first time, I was able to see a real life Crip do the Crip walk. I mean, I seen Lil Bow Wow do it, but I don't think that counts.
Like I love myself, and you got love for the West Coast, do me a favor, y'all, put that dub up behind the star. Put them up, y'all, put them up on your camera, put them up, put them up. Understand how wild to do this gangster shit, and tell them in a motherfucking wheelchair, and I can't motherfucking walk no more. So before I get them out of here, keep that dub up high, and repeat after me. Somebody say, West Side! Show the respect. Y'all make some motherfucking noise.
know it's some real pimping going on when the Archbishop Don Magic Wand shows up to the party.
See, this is the important shit right here. This is what niggas don't understand. You know what I'm saying? Everybody in there watching the show. You know what I'm saying? I ain't out here no entourage. Not drinking. Like, I'm out here getting my motherfucking mind right here so I can fuck this stage up. You understand what I'm saying? Y'all niggas be trying to do the music. Y'all think it's all about the parties. It's all about the functioning and having fun and all that shit. And it is. Because this shit is fun. It's fun when you love to do something. You always having fun. But it's not about the party. The party is the aftermath of the work. You know what, you understand what I'm saying? So, yeah, this is what I do. I'm out here dolo, solo bolo. Then I'ma go hit this motherfucking stage. I'ma fuck it up with my niggas, and then we gon' party after work.
If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be on the stage right now. I appreciate you believing me, right? I'm Silky motherfucking Slim while the DJs is getting ready to do they want to.
What's happening?
I'm feeling like Carlito.
Okay.
Y'all remember Carlito's way? When he was trying to get out the game? I'm feeling like Carlito. It's time to take the money that I made and get the fuck out of the game. These niggas acting funny. These hoes ain't acting the same. The trapping is still good, but the police after my name.
Yeah.
And I be damned if I'm back in the trenches again.
What?
I'm sitting in the pen with the rest of my friends, so I'm making moves to transition into a better position. Fucking with music, I'm elusive with the pen. Loyalty to the streets keep pulling me in, leaving the pimpin' behind. I wouldn't know where to begin. But I'm curious to see if I took rap a little more serious, would my means ever justify my ends? Well, I guess that all depends on the vision God give me when I rest my head to bed.
Yeah,
I've been through hell, I'm forgiven for my sins.
Speak on
the wrong and I write whatever that I sin. So with that said, this rap game is my new thing. My new hustle, I just gotta pursue it, man.
Yeah.
I gotta do it for everyone who believe this pimp nigga from Pine that can make it out of these streets.
Yeah,
street credit is good, I ain't breaking out of my lease. I'm breaking out of my cage, I'm way too much of a beast.
Like I said, it was a night to remember. To say I was impressed with Mr. Silky Slim is an understatement. The other artists performing that night were West Coast legends with accolades, platinum plaques, and have toured all around the world. But Silk was the underdog, still paying his dues. That was simply supposed to keep the crowd ready for the next big star. But Silky obviously didn't get the memo because he performed with the ferocious zeal of a beast uncaged for the first time. He performed as if his life depended on winning over every single fan. No special celebrity guest to help introduce him, just his hype man Tef Dollar on his side, like two bank robbers, and they stuck up Orange County for and demanded their respect. No special effects, just raw energy. With a high octane atmosphere already surrounding the building, Silky performed with a laser beam like focus. Explosive yet calm, refined yet raw, Silky moved around the stage like a lion in the jungle, as if the stage was his natural habitat. He was a Pied Piper and the crowd was paying close attention to every detail as if he had them in a trance. They were mesmerized by the music. As MC performed lyrical acrobatics with a flow and smooth delivery that can only be mimicked by a seasoned pimp. The crowd followed along as if he was a mythical being.
Fuck Donald Trump.
That can only be described as explosive. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a new star entering the hip hop galaxy, and that is the incomparable Mr. Silky Slim.
TooRealFOrTV.com.